Well, I remember really well the emails in MS-DOS, white on black. And yes, at the time, email evoked this sense of unprecedented connectedness that you couldn't feel lonely in a way, ever, perhaps. And you always, always felt excited to go and see your inbox again because you did it at very semi-regular intervals. Mm-hmm. And over the next several years, that feeling all but vanished and email became a source of stress. So I relate powerfully to your message. Now, am I the target end user?
No, it's your wife. I mean, we will be glad also having you using it, but it skews a little bit on women, even if, of course, I would say 60% women, 40% men. It's people who are not necessarily super techy, because that's an interesting distinction. Everybody does email. You know, people are different in their behaviors, and we are picking at a demographic which is of they are less intense in working through email, in foldering, in creating filters, in maybe working in two different projects, and they tend more to accumulate content within their inbox. They use the iPad at home on the couch. Sometimes they are women, maybe they are in their early 30s. They might have kids, they browse and they shop online for their kids, they find new things, maybe they look at recipes online. And that's really our persona. It's Helen, with whom, around which we have been building this in the last 6, 8, 9 months. You know?
Let's talk about the process of you arriving at your end user profile.
Yep.
In the beginning, you started with the intention of helping people fall in love with email again. How did you go from that philosophical position to an understanding of what the end user profile is?
Well, the first step was understanding where we wanted to get. And that was really the first wow moment was around the You Got Mail movie, because there was this sense of saying, oh, that is it. That is like the excitement of somebody opening their inbox. Yeah, how can we get somebody excited right now? No? And then we that led us to focus even more on personal email, because that's where there is this sense of, you know, enjoyment or whatever is in there. And that brought us also to the visuality, to where you can interact with different kind of content. That is something which is also very much in line with how we feel about how we would do email ourselves. You know, my partner, first of all, who is really the product lead in this, and he has been starting doing this for himself made women, I would say. No, his name is Jim, and so I would have done it for somebody looking like him who likes online shopping and so on, which I do too. And then as the months advanced, we started to refine the concept. At the time, we were doing something which was much techier, was a plugin for Gmail. And then we realized that people do not install plugin, they don't really know what they are. But that had allowed us a lot to play with the user during that summer. It was 1 year ago. And then we were speaking with investors or designers or people in the space. And it was this understanding that the user behavior we were looking at was typical of what was really booming in iPad. It was the moment that couch shopping was booming. And so they say, okay, this is it. That's where we have to do it. And that's also the platform where we can really innovate the most, because this is a new platform. And the email has been brought here without really being native, no? Has been a copy. Already on the phone was not it's not such a great media for email the way it's done, because it looks like on the internet it's just reduced in size. Now there are a few companies which have taken a very interesting shot at it for different demographics, I would say. But email in here, it's really nothing exciting. So you say, okay, that's the place where we're gonna start from.